Like I'd mentioned in my previous piece, I've been on holiday, and while it did leave me with a lot of good experiences, there were a lot of thoughts that I had about customer care in particular that I thought we'd talk about today. Hey, how's it going? This is Pradeep. Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so that you never miss a video. Today, we're talking about customer care in India in 2019 and certain things that it can do to not suck. There are basically three traits to good quality customer care. It needs to be fast, it needs to be seamless, it needs to be meaningful. Fast in the sense it needs to be quick for a person to interact with the business and for the business to reach out back to the customer. In a recent transaction with Make My Trip, the cab was late, I'd booked an intercity cab. I called them, they greeted me with a welcome message, they told me to keep my booking ID ready, and then they put me on hold for 5 minutes. I went about back and forth with their customer care reps for about an hour. I'd explain the problem to them, they would tell me they would call me back, it would never happen. After an hour, I canceled the cab and I booked an Uber, and that was that. It got me thinking that imagine if I'd been in a cab and then I'd had an actual emergency. It would have been impossible for me to reach out to Make My Trip, and things would have got bad really quickly. The second aspect of good customer service is seamless. Customers today are able to reach out to businesses across platforms. You have Facebook, WhatsApp, Messenger, Twitter, and the like. Good news is that it is possible for businesses to buy software which gives them a unified inbox so that they can manage customer interactions across platforms. Another aspect of seamless customer interaction is when a customer has to reach out to a business and then have to identify themselves through complicated mechanisms. In my Make My Trip example, I had to use my booking ID each and every time, which, by the way, is NC75241834951865. Yes, I had to practice that. They were simply not able to identify me through my phone number, and it was far from seamless. Another aspect of seamless customer interaction is in the case of cross-border transactions. I'd called Amazon for an order that I'd placed, and they told me that the order was routed through Amazon.com US, and I had to call them. Obviously, when I called them, they were switched off because of time zone differences. I eventually got the order resolved, but then the problem was that for me, the customer, Amazon is one and the same. I understand that there are thousands of people working in Amazon India and that there are thousands of people working in Amazon US, but they need to find a way to iron out the logistics so that the customer interaction across borders or across locations is far more seamless. A more localized example would be in the case of Aarti scans, where I had to get the report from my scan and I had to call the Tinagar branch and then go from branch to branch till I finally reached Wadapalni and got my issue resolved. The final trait of good quality customer care is that it needs to be meaningful. See, we live in a country where businesses have accrued a lot of money or that they're heavily funded. And the most common way in which they resolve a particular problem for a customer is to simply refund the money. You purchased a product for 15,000, you have an issue with it. Okay, here's a refund, take it and be happy. But I think as people evolve, they will realize that a refund will not do. I'd like to highlight an interaction that I had with Zomato customer care, where I'd ordered a particular product, the order failed, they refunded twice the amount of the order value, and they promised me to take off that restaurant from their delivery platform, which they did, and they notified me. That is a proper, meaningful customer interaction. I read an article recently which said that we are increasingly becoming good at having one person deal with even thousands or hundreds of thousands of customers and solve their issues through things like AI, machine learning, and big data. But at the same time, in this golden era of customer service, I think it's important that we remember that customers today expect good service, good care, anytime, every time, everywhere.